hundreds of thousands of people in South Asia literally scrape away at the dirt for a living in the myriads of small mines and quarries that dot this part of the world. What you're about to see is an illustration of small-scale quarrying in Bangladesh. Bangladesh is a relatively small country, about two-thirds the size of Victoria, with a population of about 150 million. It is a flat and watery country. The Ganges, through the Padma and the Brahmaputra, empty their sediments into the Bay of Bengal. And from the northern parts of Bangladesh that border Assam, the heavy monsoonal rains form rivers which combine to give you another large river called the Meghna that also goes to the Bay of Bengal. These rivers are the source of a lot of stone and sand and gravel which is washed down from the hills by the heavy monsoonal rains. The major quarrying activity occurs in the Sylhet region, and that is where we're going to go. During the non-monsoonal part of the year, up to 200,000 people may be involved in one way or another in this activity. Getting there is not always easy, along a narrow road, endless streams of trucks going one way or the other, crossing narrow one-lane bridges and hold-ups of half an hour getting across those bridges whilst you wait for a pause in the traffic is quite common.
Honey.
the boat people sort out their catch of gravel and stones into about three different size ranges, which are then dumped on the bank in the appropriate pile. A very small business, a little refreshment shop in the middle of the river. The district north of Sylhet, at the foot of these hills where the quarrying goes on, coal also arrives from Assam, as does limestone. And you're going to see the series of trucks coming through, the dumping their coal just inside Bangladesh at the checkpoint. And then a bit later on you will see limestone trucks coming in onto a dumping ground there. With regard to the limestone, at least, some form of tax or revenue is collected by the Bangladesh government.
Thank you.
Here they're breaking up the surface with a metal rod. Now, the limestone is dumped in this area, and eventually bits and pieces of it get crushed by the myriads of trucks that go past, and you've got a layer of limestone on top of the dumping ground. These people here are breaking it up and recovering it. My God, they get about 100 rupees a day for doing this. Must be a high demand for limestone, that's all I can say. The next few scenes cover more commercialised forms of stone quarrying here. Big diggers dig out the embankment and recover the boulders. This is much more extensive or productive, of course, than the individual people with boats. But it does seem that the environmental impacts are definitely greater. There are over 60 of these larger scale operations, covering an area of over 1,000 hectares. Truckload of stones going to a stockpile. Trucks are often highly decorated in this part of the world. The same sort of artists paint these scenes as do the rickshaws in Dhaka. We stayed at the Parjanan Hotel in Sylhet. It's part of a government hotel chain. Really quite comfortable. But there weren't many people there. I think we might have been the only people, certainly at dinner. Yeah.
সকল ভালোবাসা প্রভু তোমার পানে তোমার পানে তোমার পানে ধায় যেন সকল ভালোবাসা প্রভু তোমার পানে তোমার পানে তোমার পানে যায় যেন সকল গোপে আশা প্রভু তোমার কানে তোমার কানে তোমার কানে চিত্ত মম যখন যেথা থাকে সারা যেন দেশে তব ডাকে চিত্ত মম যখন যেথা থাকে সারা যেন দেশে তব ডাকে যত মধু সব টুটে গো যেন প্রভু তোমার টানে তোমার টানে তোমার টানে ধায় যেন সকল ভালোবাসা প্রভু তোমার পানে তোমার পানে তোমার পানে বাহিরে ভিক্ষা ভরা থালি এবার যেন নিঃশেষ হয় খালি অন্তরূপ গোপনে যায় ভোরে প্রভু তোমার দানে তোমার দানে তোমার দানে বাহিরে ভিক্ষা ভরা থালে এবার যেন